Awesome.
So, good afternoon to everyone. Today we will see some in the previous classes of DBMS. We have seen the ER diagram, and today we will discuss some ER diagrams that are given in the examination that can be, and through how the questions will be given and how we can perform our ER diagram, we will discuss today. Okay. So there is a question given, you can see there is a question given that an IT company has 12 instructors and it can handle up to 100 trainings. For each training session, the company offers 5 advanced technology courses, each of which is taught by a team of 2 or more instructors. Each instructor is assigned to a maximum of 2 teaching teams or may be assigned to do a research. And each training undertakes 1 advanced technology courses per training session. Now draw an ERD, means entity relationship diagram, for the above scenario. So that's how our questions will be given to you. That's how our questions will be given. And from this question, you have to draw the ER diagram. So first, what I have said, that first thing is you have to read the problem very carefully. And after reading the problem, you will find the what are the entities present in this case. So if you read this, if you read the this questions very carefully, then you can see there are how many entities present. One is, you can see, instructor. This is an entity present. 100 trainees, means trainees is an entity present. Training session, this is also an entity. And how many advanced technology, 5 advanced technology. That means this is also an entity. And course, so this is also an entity. You can see these are the 5 entities present in this problem. So first you have to what? You have to read it very carefully, because if you didn't read it carefully, then you cannot able to find what are the entities present in this problem. So first you have to, if there is any problem given, you very carefully read it. After reading, you will get how many entities are present. So that's how after reading this problem, I have get that instructor, training session, advanced technology, and course. These are the five entities present in this problem. Now, after finding the entities, what you have to do? You have to find the attributes of that particular entity. Now, in this problem, there is no attributes. The attributes that should be present for the entity, it is not given. If it is not given, then you can use your own attributes. By using own attributes, you can use it. But if in the problem, the attributes are mentioned, then that particular attribute should be what? That particular attribute should be included in your entity. But here you can see the problem. In this problem, the attributes are not mentioned. So in this case, what I have done, that attributes, if there is no attribute name given, then as your choice, you can add the attributes. So for instructor, I have chosen the attributes. I have chosen ID, IID means instructor ID. For an instructor, I have taken that three attributes are present for an instructor. Now, what are that? IID. Now, IID is the instructor ID. IID is the instructor ID. Then name of the instructor and the course. The course which is done by the instructor, which is chosen by the instructor. So that course, I have taken these attributes. If you want, you can add attributes also, but I have taken these three attributes. But if you want to add attributes, because there is attributes is not mentioned. So that means as your wish, you can add attributes and add it in your entity. So for me, I have added IID, name, and course. And for training, I have used TID, means training ID. Then name, and the trainee is admitted in which course. The trainee is admitted in which course, I have added as attribute. Then next entity, training session. Next entity is the training session. For training session, what I have done? For training session, I have used TS number, means training session number. I have used and number of hours, the number of hours. This attribute I have added in the training session. And advanced, next entity is the advanced technology. And for this advanced technology entity, I have used what attributes? CID. Then CID means course ID. For advanced technology entity, I have used CID, that is course ID, name, training session number, and training ID. We have used that. Okay. So I have used that for course ID, name, training session number, and training ID. And for course, I have used only one attribute, that is duration of the course. Now, This I have used. Okay. So here we have taken the what? We have taken the attributes. After, because here the attributes are not mentioned. So as of my wish, I have written these attributes. If you wish to write any other attributes, that means for in this instructor case, you can add instructor address, instructor phone number. You can add that. It is up to you. But I have chosen only these three attributes. But if in the problem it is mentioned that this attribute should be present, then what? You have to use only that attributes. Otherwise, you didn't able to do that type. Okay. So now we find the what? Our entities and the attributes are added. Now we will go to draw the picture. We will draw the picture of the entity relationship diagram. So for entity relationship diagram, you can see. So first, you can see the entity relationship diagram. Now, how many attributes are present? We have said that the attributes are present is of The attributes, what are the attributes present? We can see that there are attributes present: trainee, trainee session, instructor, advanced technology course. So these attributes are, these entities are present. We have seen that trainee, trainee session, advanced technology course, and instructor. Now, at first, I have done for trainee. It is an entity. So for entity, we have to mention it into the rectangular boxes. In the rectangular boxes, we have to mention the entity. And you have to, in this Eclipse format, you have to mention the attributes of that particular entity. So for trainee, what we have used for trainee, I have used course ID. I have used course ID attributes, then training ID. Then we have used what? Training ID and the name of the training. So these three attributes are added. And for training session, what we have done for training session, I have used two attributes, training session number and number of hours. So these two attributes are present of the training session entity. So, okay, now this, what is the relationship between these two entities? Now, if we carefully follow the problem, then what it is written? That a company has 12 instructor. A company has 12 instructor and can handle up to 100 trainees for each training session. 100 trainee for each training session. Now, the relationship between, it is said that 100 trainees can be admitted to one training session. So that means what? We have done the relationships. You see, we have done the relationship. That is, trainee is admitted. The relationship is admitted to the training session. The trainee is admitted to the training session. Now, what in the problem given? That 100 trainees can be what? Admitted in the each training session. So that's why we have used 100, and here in the relationships, we have used one. That means 100 trainee can be admitted to each training session. So that means 100 trainee can be admitted to one training session. So this is the relationship between these two, 100, and this will be one. In vice versa, if we check that it is made possible also that in one training session, one training may present, it may happen. It in every cases, there is not possible that every training session, there will be 100 trainees present. May that case happen that in a particular training session, only one trainee can be attended. So that's why in vice versa case, we have used one and one. So these are the relationships. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So that's how from the problem, you have to evaluate this. From the problem, you should go like this approach. From if you take this approach, then it will be very much clear to you. So the main thing is you have to very carefully read the problem. Because if you didn't understand the problem clearly, then you cannot do the ERD diagram. So that's why I have always mentioned it, that for doing the ERD diagram, you have to very carefully, not one time, try to read it two or three times, the same problem two or three times. You read that, then it will be very much clear that what the problem is saying. Because if it is not clear that what the problem is saying, you cannot do what? You cannot do this ERD diagram. So first is made. Now, after that, what I have done? The next relationships, we have to do the next relationships. Now here you can see, I have written that trainee undertakes advanced technology course. Okay. So now it is mentioned here that trainee and advanced technology course. So what are the relationships between them? If you see in the problem, it is already mentioned that the company offers five advanced technology courses. The company offers five technology courses. That means what? That means the trainee, because who will undertake the advanced technology course? The trainee undertakes the advanced technology course. Now what? There are only five advanced technology courses present. So that means what? It may happen that a particular trainee undertakes five advanced technology course, because here what is mentioned that maximum five advanced technology courses. The company offers five advanced technology courses. That means a particular trainee can undertake what? We can assume that a particular trainee that undertakes five advanced technology courses. It may happen that a trainee can attend what? Five advanced technology courses. That's why it is written one and it is five. Because the company offers five advanced technology courses. In the program, it is already mentioned. So that means what? A particular trainee can undertake five advanced technology courses. And the vice versa, it is also present. In vice versa, if we check that for one advanced technology courses, one trainee can attend one advanced technology courses. It also may happen that like that, one trainee undertakes five advanced technology courses. But it may happen also that one advanced technology courses that is attended by a single trainee. So that means it will be 1:1 relationships. It is 1:1 relationships. Now, the other entity which is present, is the instructor. Now, what is the relationship between instructor and the advanced technology courses? If you mindly observe that, you can see that what is mentioned, a company has 12 instructor and can handle up to what? 100 trainee. And for each training session, the company offers five advanced technology courses, and each of which is taught by a team of two or more instructor. So what it will be? There will be the five advanced technology courses means the instructor is teaching the advanced technology courses, because he or she is the person in the company that they teaching the advanced technology courses. He or she is teaching the advanced technology courses. That means what is mentioned? That instructor, it will be made that, if you see, it is what? The instructor taught the advanced technology courses. Now, there are how many advanced technology courses present? There are five advanced technology courses present. So first, if we take the relationship, then what it is written? That for one advanced technology course, there will be more than two instructors should be present. That means what? Here, the relationship will be what? 1:2. Because the question, it is mentioned that a particular advanced technology courses can be taught by what? Can be taught by two or more than two instructor. So that means what? We have the relationships between them will be one advanced technology course and two instructor. Two or more than two, but here I have used the list that is mentioned. So I am using two. That means the value will be 1:2. So that's why here one is written and here two is written. The same is also what? That there are only five advanced technology courses present, and in the company, the number of instructor is what? The number of instructor is 12. So that means this 12 instructor can taught these 5 advanced technology courses, because it is already mentioned in the problem that in the company 12 instructor is present and there are 5 advanced technology courses present. That means this 12 instructor will do or the taught these 5 advanced technology courses. That means it is 12 and it will be 5. So that's how this ER diagram is mentioned. And in the problem, it is also mentioned that I have used the instructor as a 2 type. For instructor, it may be a faculty or a researcher. It may happen that the instructor, whoever the instructor is, the instructor may be a faculty or may be a researcher. It can happen. So that's why we can say that it is the is a relationship. We can say this is a relationship. So instructor is a. So is a relationship should be written like this. This is a relationship should be written. If there is an is a relationship, then it will be drawn like this. Okay. So this instructor, now this instructor can be a faculty or a researcher. It may happen. So that's how I have divided them with 2. Now today we'll see the specialization and generalization part. So this is the specialization. So this is the specialization part. So instructor is maybe a faculty or a researcher. So that's how the ER diagram can be done. So it is clear? It is clear to you how this ER diagram I have done?
Sir, can you once again explain that 2, 12 part, sir? Taught by 2 instructor.
Yes. I am mentioning that. Here, first part in the problem, you can see in the problem, it is already mentioned. If you see the problem very carefully, that it is mentioned that offers 5 technology courses, 5 advanced technology courses, and each of which is taught by a team of 2 or more instructors. So each of which is taught by a team of 2 or more instructors. So that means what? A particular advanced technology course that is mentioned, that each of which is taught by a team of 2 members. So that means what? A particular advanced technology course is what? Taught by 2 or more than 2 instructors. But for we have that in the relationship, we didn't take the least value. What it is mentioned? 2 or more instructor. That means we will take only 2. Okay. So that means what? There will be 1 present in the advanced technology course, in the side of advanced technology course. What? This will be 1 minute. This will be 1, because for each advanced technology course, 2 or more than 2 instructors can take that. So we have to take the list. The list is mentioned, because otherwise we can didn't find the relationships. So that's why here I mentioned 1 advanced technology course and it is taught by 2 instructor. Okay. Same as that, vice versa. If you see in the problem, it is mentioned that 12 instructor is present in a company. Now this 12 instructor will only take this 5 advanced technology course, because in this company only 12 instructor is present. That means what? This 12 instructor has to take this 5 advanced technology course. That's why it is mentioned 12 and 5. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So that's how we have to draw the ER diagram. And this is a specialization. Now, before starting the specialization and generalization, I should mention that what is specialization and generalization. Now, specialization is like that any of you tell that I am a BTech student. Now, what is this? this is the generalized format that you are a BTech student. Okay. But if you mention that I am a BTech student of computer science department, then that means what? You specially mention your specialization. Your specialization is that you are specialized. That means you are a student of computer science department. Then what? Computer science department of BTech engineering. But if you, again, you can divide that I am a second year student of computer science engineering branch of Cyber Engineering College and BTech. So that means what? We are doing the specialization. The generalization view is you're a BTech student. Okay, this is the generalization view. But if we say that I am a computer science engineering student of BTech computer science engineering student. So that means what? This is the specialization. If it may or be specialized, that means if you mention that I am the second year student of CSC, that means what? This is more specialized. So specialization is that. And generalization view is like you are the BTech student. So this is the base of the specialization and generalization. Clear?
Yes, sir.
So that's why, what? If you mention that, I will show the example. I will again show the example, then it will be more clear. That vehicle. Now this vehicle may have what? This vehicle may have two-wheeler, or this vehicle may have four-wheeler, or this vehicle may have eight-wheeler. Now inside the two-wheeler, you mentioned what? The two-wheeler, a bicycle, and a bike. So that means what? This is a specialized bicycle and bike. This is a specialized. This is a specialized. But if we see, if we can say the general view, that means what? The general view is what? The general view is vehicle. Same as that, here I have mentioned instructor. But an instructor can happen, that instructor may be a faculty or a researcher. So this is what? Faculty and researcher, this is the specialized. This is the specialized format. And instructor is basically what? Generalized format. Clear? So the ERD, basically the ERD is clear to everyone. So how we can do the entity relationship diagram? So if you practice it, you can do it. You will able to do it if you practice it.
Yes, sir.
So, Aditya, if any questions from this?
Clear, sir.
Okay. So main thing, you have to practice this. Okay. I have taken the examples and use this. There is all example. There is many examples. Like this is a second example. You have to do what? I will give you this example that I will give you some problems of ERD. Okay. So what do you think and how I have done this? You should do that. I will give some problems. Okay. There are some ERD. And what do you think? What is relationships between the entities that present in the problem? You will do that. Okay. So next we will move. This is another ERD. Okay, this is another ERD diagram. The question is like this, the questions will be mentioned. So this problem, in this problem, you see what is mentioned? A company stores information about the current working employees. The information includes employee number, name, salary, date of join, address, and phone number. Now you see the employee is what? The employee is the entity, and its attributes its attributes are already mentioned here. That it is attributes are given here. You can see employee number, name, salary. So that means employee entity contains these attributes. Okay. And next, what is mentioned that each employee works for a department. So that means this is another entity because department is also another entity. On a particular project, that means project. Project is also an what? Project is also an entity. So for a particular number of hours, the information about the department, now department entity will includes what? Attributes, department number, department name, and each department controls some projects current by running in the company. So each department is managed by a particular employee who becomes the manager of that department. The project information includes project number, project name, and its description. Means the project entity has these attributes, project number, project name, etc. And a department is only managed by one manager. And one manager is dedicated to only one department. So this means what? This means the relationships. This means the relationships of the problem. And a department can control any number of projects, but one project can be handled by only one department. Okay. So from this problem, you can able to do this problem. I will give it, if I give this, you can do this problem.
Yes, sir.
Okay, I will give it, okay? So you practice that problem, then it will be clear, okay? So we will move the generalization and specialization format. So here it is given, design a specialization generalization hierarchy for a motor vehicle sales company. The company sells motorcycle, passengers cars, vans, buses. So justify your placement of attributes at each level of hierarchy and explain why they shouldn't be placed. Means like you have to do what? You have to generalization and specialization. Now, here you can see what I have mentioned. I said that vehicle, in the vehicle. So you can see in the vehicle is the what? First vehicle is mentioned. And now the vehicle is divided into two parts because vehicle can be of two parts, non-commercial vehicle and commercial vehicle. So we have written it what? It is written at a is a relationship. So that means what? A vehicle can be non-commercial or vehicle can be a commercial also. Again, we can able to divide the non-commercial section into two parts. That in non-commercial section, two-wheeler vehicles means two-wheeler. Two-wheeler can be also non-commercial and four-wheeler is also can be a commercial. In case of non-commercial, three-wheeler will be a commercial and six-wheeler. These two types we can divide. Then again, two-wheeler can be what? Motorcycle, bike, or bicycle, we can divide that. Four-wheeler can be what? Four-wheeler can be the cars, passenger cars. The cars can be four-wheeler. And three-wheeler, what? The three-wheeler can be? Three-wheeler can be the van. And six-wheeler is what? The bus. So you can see, first, we can say that vehicle is the generalized view. Then we divide the vehicle into two parts. One is non-commercial, another one is commercial. So we can able to divide that based on this part. We can able to divide. Then we again divide that non-commercial can be of two types, two-wheeler and four-wheeler. And as a case of commercial, it is of two types, three-wheeler and six-wheeler. Again, we can able to divide that two-wheeler. That is, a two-wheeler can be a motorcycle or what? A bicycle. It can be like that. Four-wheeler can be what? A car is a four-wheeler. Then what is the three-wheeler? Three-wheeler is basically in the commercial section. Three-wheeler is what? A van, an auto. That can be the three-wheeler. Or the six-wheeler is what? Six-wheeler will be a bus. So this is what the vehicle is what? The generalized view. And what this we are here, we are using the generalization and specialization format. Okay, so that's how the specialization can be done. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Huh.
How many maximum number of specialization can
it is possible? Up to you. It is up to you. Okay, it is up to you that how many, but you have to divide. You have to divide in such a position that after that, the division is not possible. Like if you divide, you can able to divide motorcycle or bicycle. Again, it can be divided from motorcycle. There is already two wheelers. Okay. So it can be divided. It is the last. It is the last. We cannot divide the motorcycle or cannot divide the bicycle. So up to what level you can divide? You have to divide up to that level. And if you didn't able, after that you didn't able to derive, then stop in that position. But up to what level you can able to divide, you have to divide that up to that level. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Basically, motorcycle को हम divide कर सकते हैं कुछ तरीके से और bicycle को हम कुछ तरीके से divide कर सकते हैं नहीं कर सकते हैं ना इसको हम divide कैसे करेंगे ठीक है
company पे sir
हाँ अब देखो हम इधर तुम जो बोल रहे हो कि मोटरसाइकिल का कंपनी देखो मोटरसाइकिल का कंपनी इधर क्या है इधर तो हम वो एट्रीब्यूट लेके डिवाइड नहीं कर रहा है हम उस बेस में डिवाइड नहीं कर रहे तब हम उसको लेना था व्हीकल्स कंपनी फर्स्ट टाइम जब जनरलाइजेशन व्यू होना चाहिए था तब व्हीकल्स कंपनी होना चाहिए था तब व्हीकल्स कंपनी का बेसिस से हम डिवाइड कर सकते थे तब व्हीकल्स कंपनी का बेसिस में हमको डिवाइड करना होता है बट हम लोग क्या लिए हम लिए है व्हीकल्स ओनली तब क्या था कि हाँ तुम ले सकते हो व्हीकल्स कंपनी इज अ तुम ले रहे हो जो जो कंपनी है तुम सब कंपनी का नाम ले रहे हो मतलब ये सब कंपनी क्या है व्हीकल्स के अंदर प्रेजेंट है व्हीकल्स कंपनी के अंदर वो तुम कर सकते थे
सर मोटरसाइकिल में सर बाइक और स्कूटी ऐसा हो सकता है डिवाइड
अब तुम जो इसको मोटरसाइकिल दिए हो मोटरसाइकिल को तुम कर सकते हो बाइक और स्कूटी में डिवाइड कर सकते हो मोटरसाइकिल जो है तुम बाइक और स्कूटी में कर सकते हो एज अ उसको कर सकते हो तुम
सर कांट वी डिवाइड टू व्हीलर्स इन मोटराइज्ड एंड नॉन मोटराइज्ड सेक्शंस
एज यू विश इट इज अप टू यू दैट हाउ यू डिवाइड It is up to you. There is no constant rule present that it should be do or it should be not done. It is up to you. Like your entity relationship diagram and specialization generalization format. What you think you should do there? Only the other person should able to understand that. It is up to you that how you divide, how you use, how entities should be used. It is up to you totally. And that's why you think one way you can think and the other will think in another way. It is possible that everyone's entity relationship diagram will be not same. It is possible. It is up to you that how you think. I have used this, but it is not the rule that it should be followed. But how you think that is that will be not accepted. It is not that. Okay.
Okay, sir.
So only one thing is you have to divide the way.